Oh, hey guys.
Okay.
Oh, we got the roll.
All right, so yeah, we want to play first. Like this deck really you have to mulligan, right? Like, okay, this is keepable because Nest Invader. Like, one of the reasons Nest Invader is actually really good in this deck is because no one wants to kill a spawn token.
Yeah.
Like a single spawn token. The only thing is like the extra Raging Ravine kind of makes the turns a little awkward.
Yeah, if the Raging Ravine is something else, that would have been better.
But
But we
it's
still
a
have
it
enough on tap lands.
All right, so I just run Nest Invader out at this point. And then like next turn,
You
I
Blubbered
think
Elf?
yeah.
So you go Forest, Blubbered
I
Elf?
mean, if by for some like if he actually does kill the token.
Is this Invader a 2-2? That's pretty sick. Is he bolting it?
Sweet. We
Oh no.
want
Alright, that's good. Thanks, guy.
the token. If he's playing Red Deck Wins, I'm totally cool with that. Oh,
I
he's
mean,
playing Red Deck Wins.
if he's playing Red Deck Wins, does he really want to waste his burn on your Nest Invader?
Well, essentially, burst is the two damage that he's going to deal to me.
I mean, I guess.
It's not the most effective play, but like at this point, I bring out like I just cast Bloodraid Elf this turn. Like it
Yeah.
won't matter.
Good card.
Let's see if I can Lotus Cobra
Play Bloodraid Elf?
and play Bloodraid Elf.
You wanna do that? That seems good.
Sick.
How good is we?
The Wii is awesome, but so is everything that's Nintendo based. Yes. Red. Hey, like I've actually messed that
Oh, you're
up.
getting an island, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Is Jace good against Red Deck Wins?
Jace is definitely if you cast him later in the game, it's great because he'll give you back all the cards that you spent to survive. If you cast him early in the game, he absorbs damage most of the time.
Oh,
All
that
right.
seems good.
Yeah, it's basically just like extra fodder against red deck. All right. Did you do Frost Titan is actually pretty sweet.
Do you swing for three?
Yeah. Because there's like I'm not gonna block. Like if you ball
I mean, you
lightnings,
could still block with Nest Invader. Oh, well, if you ball lightnings, yeah, you don't do
like
it.
more than likely he'll probably like
Just unearth?
unearth and then like drop Teetering Peaks or something.
Yeah. There any first strikers we could get our hands on?
No.
That seems pretty sick.
But I'm gonna have bolts like next turn. Actually, let's see. Next turn I can activate Raging Ravine.
And still have bolts up or no?
Yeah, if depending on what he does. And then I can put the pressure on him. Like can outracing red deck wins.
Oh, it's Tonic Edge.
Oh. That's a little sad.
Oh, but he tapped it.
Yeah, like I take the three. It's not worth blocking at this point. Yeah, I'm gonna have to activate Raging Ravine, like.
Yeah, because it's gonna die now anyway.
Oh.
So much for that.
That changes the plays up a bit.
We're still winning though, right?
Yeah.
Like, he has four cards in hand. See if we rip the rolling terrain and just rolling terrain
Okay.
into Tonic
So let's
Edge.
see if seven, nine. No, it's not enough. Especially if, like he'll Tectonic Edge, so I won't be able to actually like use it. It's better just keep the bolt up. Like I'll play the other Raging Ravine, so it's like okay, no matter what you do, it's futile.
Swing.
Yeah. If it was like I it's probably because of how popular Primeval Valakut decks are.
That they're running Tonic. I mean, if you're running a monocolor deck, I've always been an advocate of getting to Tonic Edge. It just seems totally worth it. You know, like, what are you really losing from it?
Let's see what he does here.
Kraken Dragonlord? Is that what it's called?
Cargan.
Kargan? It's
Okay.
fine.
And he did go for the one that was untapped. Yeah, at this point I do bolt it.
Do you bolt it now?
Like next turn I'm gonna be swinging with Raging Ravine, so it's gonna be actually wait, let's see something here.
Cause what if next turn he
Two
has
no
a
actually
Teetering
I think
Peaks?
next turn I win next turn. If I bolt him. Like two, three, four. So
Okay.
that's 7, 9, 12. So I take the three.
Okay.
And I win.
Yeah.
When you run good, you run good.
And there's nothing he can do.
Yeah, like he's top dog and everything.
Doesn't Wait, hold on. You don't. No, 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 stop.
What?
Oh, okay. You bolt him at end of turn. Okay. Yeah. All right. I was like, you don't have red green. Even with like a terrible draw.
That was pretty sweet. And now we win.
This turn, this game, you win the math race, Lewis.
That was a.
Exactsies again.
Exactsies, so beautiful.
This guy's pissed. All right, so what do you bring in against him?
Against him, Caller? You bring in Burst Lightning, Basilisk Caller, Spellbreaker Behemoth because you want the body.
Do you take out Jace? And Frost Titan?
No, you take out. Acidic Slime is actually not, like, the Death Touch means nothing.
Yeah.
Like, Death Touch means nothing. Rune Blaster pretty much means nothing. Like, it's just, you want to cascade into, like, burn. Rolling Terrain is actually not important. Like, at this point, I bring the Cunning Spark Mage.
Yeah. Because
then he either has to burn it, or I stop his Hull Sparks
every time. Yeah, because you just ping his, yeah.
And then, like, I keep Jason.
And the Cross Titans just in case, yeah.
Actually, the fun part, like, I've actually won because of Spreading Seas.